Good morning, good morning. Hey there, Heartbeat Mama Hardy. How are you this morning? Hey, Heartbeat Doris, Heartbeat Rodney, Heartbeat Eva, Heartbeat Rachelle. Good morning, Heartbeat Sherry. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Happy Wednesday, winning Wednesday, wonderful Wednesday. Hey, Heartbeat Melodia. Hey, Heartbeat Yvette. Good morning, good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Juanita. Good morning. Hey, Heartbeat Elaine and Heartbeat Donald, Heartbeat Alicia. Good morning, good morning, good morning to you guys. You have made it. It's the middle of the week. Two more days. You got this. You've got this. Good morning, good morning, good morning, and welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to Wholeness, aka the Heart Gatherer. And today, your daily dosage, we're continuing on with Ready, Set, Go, Part 3 on this morning. And so we're going to pick right up. We're going to go back to Luke 1. And we're going to start again with verse 35. We're talking about being ready to move when God tells us to move. We're talking about not allowing our circumstances to keep us stagnated when we hear the word of God. And so we all know this as the Christmas story. You know, most pastors preach about it during the holiday season, but we're looking at it today. We're in verse 35, and it says, "And the angel answered and said to her, 'The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore also that the Holy One is to be born will be called the Son of God. Now indeed, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is now the sixth month for her who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible.' Then Mary said, 'Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word.' And the angel departed from her." And so this is where we ended on yesterday, where she gets the angel is talking to her. He gives her a glimpse. He tells her about Elizabeth. She says, "Hey, listen, you know, I've never been with a man before, but be it unto me. If that's what the Lord is saying, I'm rolling with it. I'm going with it." And that has to be the attitude that we take when we hear the voice of God. When God tells us something, we've got to rock with it. We've got to roll with it. Whether or not we are comfortable with it, whether or not we agree with it, we've got to roll with it. Amen. Verse 39 says, "Now Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste to a city of Judah and entered the house of Zacharias and greeted Elizabeth." And this is what I like about Mary. See, here God is giving her a glimpse of what to come. The angel already told her, "Hey, listen," you know, to reassure her, "Hey, listen, Elizabeth is pregnant." What does she do? She gets up and she goes. And what am I saying on this morning? When God gives you a word, he's always giving us a glimpse, a peek about what's to happen. But you've got to heed the voice of God. You see, Mary didn't waste any time. It said with haste, she got up and she went on, and she was able to see what the angel had already told her. And that's what happens with us. When you get up, when it's like ready, set, go, and you hear God tell you something and you begin to move, you will see what he said. See, here's the thing. We usually don't see it because we don't move. You've got to go when God tells you to go, because God is never going to give you everything at one time. You couldn't handle it. He's going to give you pieces, but you won't know step three if you don't get up and move from step one to step two so that you can get to step three. And so he shows her this glimpse to let her know, "You heard me right." So she goes. So let's pick back up. We're in we are in verse 41. And here's the other thing, the reason why you must go. It's not always just for you. Amen. So 41 says, "And it happened when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary that the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit." And so you see, once Mary got there, it caused a reaction in Elizabeth. So here's another reason, like I just said, you got to know that it's not always about you. The thing that God is telling you to do is for others. It's for his glory. And so, you've got to know, just like when somebody's carrying a child, right? mothers, grandmothers that I'm talking to on this morning, when you come around, people get excited, right? They're like, what are you having? You know, how long has it been? I know you can't wait. It's like you cause a reaction. Why? Because you're carrying something. You're carrying life, and everybody's waiting on you to birth this baby. Well, that's what's going on in the spirit realm. You are called to do a certain thing. And when you go around certain people that you're supposed to be connected to or that are connected to you, you cause a reaction, because here comes the answer to my prayer. Here comes the answer to my problem. Here comes a ray of sunshine when I don't have any hope. And so you've got to know that when God calls you to do something, it's not always about you, but it's to help somebody else. It's to advance the kingdom. And so this is the reason why Elizabeth, the baby in Elizabeth's belly began to leap, because of who Mary is or who Mary was. And so it goes on to say, then she spoke out with a loud voice and said, blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. See, that thing that's on the inside of you, people want to know about it. People are waiting. You know, the Bible says that the world is waiting. The earth is waiting for the sons and the daughters. You know, they are waiting on us to see what it is that God is doing. They're waiting on us to see what the kingdom of God is doing. And so you've got to know that. So you've got to know that you can't just, you know, be in your own feelings. You've got to do what God has called you to do. Doc Addison says it like this. He says, don't let your circumstances try to break you down before your breakthrough comes. Don't let your circumstances try to break you down before your breakthrough comes. And see, sometimes we can get so into our own feelings. You can't allow your feelings to dictate the level of your faith. Sometimes we get into our own feelings and we're not able to do what God has called us to do. But Doug Addison says it so well, I'm gonna quote him again. Don't let your circumstances try to break you down before your breakthrough comes. See, when it's ready, set, go time, it's time for you to go, because you're getting closer to your breakthrough. And so it's like this, when you go on the scene, when you go around those people that you're connected to, it's like a domino effect. You begin to inspire them. You begin to ignite them. You begin to encourage them, because you're just what they needed. You're just what they needed to push them to the next level. See, think about it. Somebody was always pushing you. You're not where you are today all on your own. There was someone who encouraged you. There was someone who pushed you. So again, your ready, set, go moments is not just about you, but it's about advancing the entire kingdom of God. The scripture ends, it says, for indeed, as soon as the voice of the greeting sounded in my ears, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. Blessed is she who believed, for where there will be a fulfillment of those things which were told her from the Lord. And see, all of these things happen because Mary believed the word that she heard from the angel from God. And so you've got to be just like Mary. You've got to believe the word of God that you hear. When God tells you something, you've got to be so close to God that you don't doubt it. You know, we have a tendency to do that, especially when it's something that we don't want to do or that is going to take us out of our comfort zone. We're quick to say, God, is that you? But if God tells you a word about he's getting ready to send money your way, or he's getting ready to send promotion, we're quick to be like, I receive it. You've got to be that way, whatever God says to you. And so Mary is a great example of ready, set, go. She didn't waver. You know, she asked the question, how could this be when I don't know a man? I've never known a man. And when the angel explained it to her, she said, be it unto me. And so that has got to be your stance in this position of ready, set, go. When God speaks a word to your spirit, when God speaks a word to your heart, you've got to be saying, just like Mary, be it unto me. That God, whatever it is that you're calling me to do, that I'm going to do it, because I realize it's not about me. That somebody is waiting on the other side for me to walk into that room. Somebody is waiting for me to open up my mouth and declare that you are Lord. Somebody is waiting for me to use the gift that you have placed on my life. Somebody is just waiting, because when I enter the room, it's Jesus Christ entering the room. I sound like Jesus. I look like Jesus. I smell like Jesus. Getting back to last week, week. I give off that aroma. I'm that coffee bean that changes the atmosphere when I walk in a room. And so Heartbeat Nation is ready, set, go, part three. This is your daily dosage for today. When God speaks a word to you, you've got to be ready, set, go. Go where God has told you to go, that the world may get the reaction that it needs, that it may bow, that it may come down on their knees and declare that Jesus is Lord, that we will begin to see the prophetic word, that every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. That can only happen if we, his sons and daughters, follow the word, follow the blueprint that he has for our lives, that we may walk in all the ways of God and lead others to do the same. Amen. So listen, if you have not subscribed to the YouTube channel already, please do so, because there you can find all of your dosages in one place. According to Heartbeat Keynotes, it will not kill, but it will heal. Amen. Follow me on social media platforms. God Wants Me Whole. Visit the website, GodWantsMeWhole.org. You know how we do this thing. Say, God wants me whole, and I am getting whole by the minute. Again, I'm Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness, aka the Heart Gatherer. I love you guys a bunch, and I will see you right back here tomorrow morning at 7:30 a.m. Hey there, Heartbeat Constance. Hey there, Heartbeat Linda. I saw you guys pop up afterwards. Hey, Heartbeat Troy. Hey, Heartbeat Anita. I think those are all of the ones that I may have missed. Hey, Heartbeat Bernice. Good morning to you again. Have a speck wow amazing day. Look out for falling blessings, because they are falling all around you. Last closing. I'll see you guys in the morning at 7:30 a.m. Ready, set, go.